help you, heal you, bless you. Let's give God praise in advance for this great word that's coming. Hallelujah. All right, praise the Lord. Now we answered that question. The question was, is he faithful? And the answer is what? Yes, you better know it. Well, let's pray and let's get started. Father, we thank you, bless you, and praise you for this opportunity to handle and hear and receive your holy word. I decrease that Holy Ghost, you would increase, and all of us decrease, that we can hear from your holy hill and you can speak to us, and we would not only hear the word but walk in the word. So we just give you thanks for this life-changing word, and let every soul say, in the name of Jesus,
in the name of Jesus,
I came to receive,
I came to receive,
and I will receive,
and I will receive
revelation knowledge,
revelation knowledge,
that teaches me,
that teaches me
who I am in Christ,
who I am in Christ,
what I received in Christ,
what I received in Christ,
and what I can do in Christ. To the glory of God, Jesus' name, amen. Give God one more hand clap of praise. Amen. All right. In the book of Genesis, chapter number 22, book of Genesis, holy Bible, holy people, holy teaching, Genesis chapter 22, and verses 7 and 8. Verses 7 and 8. And it reads, and Isaac spoke unto Abraham, his father, and said, my father? And his father said, here I am, son. And he said, behold the fire and the wood, but where is the lamb for a burnt offering? And Abraham said, my son, God will provide himself a lamb for a burnt offering. So they went, both of them, together. Church, I'm teaching from the life-changing, life-building, life-blessing message entitled, God Will Make a Way.
Amen.
I said, God will make a way. Can you say that with me?
God will make a way.
Amen to God. And I want to welcome you online as well as you here in person. Praise God that we can hear a word today. God will make a way. Let's look back at the text and see what God is saying here. This is Abraham and his promised child, Isaac. We know that Abraham had been promised a promised child when he was childless. Amen? And I say promised child not only because God promised this child, but because the child was the first son that Abraham was going to have, through whom the lineage of Jesus Christ would come. In other words, God made Abraham a promise. He said, in thee shall all nations of the earth be blessed. Translation, through you, Abraham, I'm going to bring forth the Messiah. Through you, Abraham, I'm going to bring forth the deliverer. Through you, Abraham, I'm going to bring forth the Savior. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
So he told Abraham this when Abraham was sonless, when Abraham was childless. And if you remember last week, I told you that he told Abraham this when Abraham was 75 years old. Amen.
Amen.
And Abraham believed him, like my wife said this morning, somewhat. He believed him somewhat. In other words, he's like the man that said, I believe, but help me with my unbelief.
Yeah.
Sometimes we could be like that. Because he believed him for 11 years. So if God told him that when he was 75 years old, let's do the math. 75 plus 11 is what?
86.
So now he's 86 years old, and 11 years have gone by, and his belief is kind of withering, it's kind of waning, right? And his wife said, hey, look, doesn't seem like God's coming through. Let's help him out. How many of us have been in a situation where God promised us something and 11 years went by, 10 years went by, 20 years went by, and what God said hadn't happened yet? Somebody say, it doesn't mean it can't happen. Say, it doesn't mean God lied. It means God is trying to tell you to hold on to your hope. He's trying to tell you to hold on to hope. Because God's timing is not our timing, right? But listen, 11 years went by, and they said, look, that's enough time for you, God. They've done something, so you ain't going to do something. We got to do something. If you ain't going to, listen, if you're not going to bless me with this wealth that you said you were going to bless me, because I'm going to go out and rob a bank. Somebody say, don't do it. You see what I'm saying? You try to make it happen on your own instead of hanging in there and doing what God said, and that is what? Wait upon the Lord. Turn to your name and say, wait upon the Lord.
Wait upon the Lord.
So now you can see that there was a problem. But like I told you, this is the key thing I want us to get today. And that is a statement. It's a key statement, Sister Camille. And that is, it says, God will make a way even when you and we don't see a way. There it is right there. This is what I want you to get today. Let's say that together. Say, God will make a way,
even when I don't see a way.
Now that's the key right there. If you can get this in your heart, if we can get this in our hearts, we will always be hopeful. We will always be full of hope, and we will never get off course. We will never be a victim. We will always be a victor. We won't have a victim mentality because our mentality will not be based on what it looks like or seems like. I said, God will make a way even when we don't what? See a way. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
If you're going to base your life only on what you see, then you can forget it. Because God did not plan your existence like that. Once you come into the kingdom, you have to walk by faith and not by sight. And I got another one for you. You have to walk by hope and not, you have to wait by hope and not by sight.
Amen.
Oh, let me say that again. You have to walk by faith and what?
Not by sight.
Well, I got a new one for you. You have to wait by hope and not by sight. In other words, when you have faith, you are walking. But when you have hope, you are what?
Waiting.
You're waiting. You're waiting patiently. It doesn't matter what it looks like. Well, I don't see how this is going to work. I don't have no money in the account. I don't see how this is going to work. I don't have any children. So here they were, 86 years old, and nothing was happening. Nothing was shaking. But then what happened? They found out that when they tried to do it their way, it didn't work. So then God picks this back up now. God picks this back up, and he's going to teach them something. He's going to teach them about hope. Look at this other statement. It says, our confidence in God's future deliverance. Our confidence in God's future deliverance should be based on our certainty of his past performance. I'm going to say that again. Our confidence of God's future deliverance should be based upon what? Our certainty of his past performance. Now, when Abraham was 86 years old, he wasn't certain. Because God had not shown him his miraculous power yet, so he started wavering and trying to make it happen himself. But I got news for you. Now he's 99 years old. So this is 13 years later. 13 years after that when he was 86 is 24 years later after he was 75. But the point is, it takes a while to build up your confidence. Now he's talking and he's a little more confident, but he's still not quite there. And God tells him, look, Abraham, you're 99 years old and it's time for you to have this child. He's like, look, if I didn't have it when I was 86, how am I going to have it when I was 99? So the brother man starts laughing. He starts laughing. God ever told you something that seems so great and so amazing? You started, you know, chuckling and said, ooh, how could that happen? How can I be on the cover of a magazine? Oh, wow, how can I start my own business? Oh, that's really a nice thought, but oh, God, I don't see how that could happen. He started laughing, and God said, yeah, well, you keep laughing because I'm going to get the last laugh because it's going to happen. And when Abraham was 100 years old, somebody said, it happened. Oh, yeah. They had a child. Abraham was 100, and Sarah was how old? She was 90. She was 90. So let's pick it up. It says, God gave Abraham a son at 99 years of age. He gave him a son at 99 years of age. That was 16 years later. Abraham, now, he gives him the son at 99 years of age, but now 16 years later, Abraham's confidence in God is great. In other words, now that he's seen this miracle, he's seen what God has done, he's like, you know what? God can do anything, so I have confidence. Here's the point. Your confidence in what God can do in the future is based on your certainty of what God has done in the past. This is what I'm trying to get you to get. Now, you say, but I wish I could be that certain because God didn't give me a child at 100 years old. But I'm telling you, he has given you a miracle. Has God given anybody in here a miracle?
Yeah.
Wait a minute. Has God given anybody in here a miracle?
Yeah.
I see some hands up, but I see not some hands up. And here's what I want you to know, hands that are not up. God has given you a miracle. It's called your salvation. You didn't deserve it. You didn't earn it. And the fact that you have been forgiven by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of your testimony is a miracle. Give God some praise. You're a miracle. You being a born-again believer and being able to talk to God and hear from God, that's a miracle. Somebody say, that's a miracle. Say, I'm a miracle walking. Yeah, you really are. Now, guess what? The fact that God did that is it should be enough basis for you to know that God, if what God did in your past should be enough basis for you to believe what God can do in your future.
Amen.
If God's, like the song says, saved a wretch like me, if God can save a wretch like you, he can do anything.
Amen.
I said, if God can clean up, save up, bless up, deliver up a wretch like you and me, he can do anything. Amen?
Amen.
Well, this was the kind of mentality that Abraham had. He said, wait a minute now. He said, I know that God did a miracle in my life. I know that he gave me a son when I was 100 years old. Now we fast forward, and Isaac's, you know, 15 years, thereabouts old, 15, 16 years old. And so now he has confidence based upon what? What God did. See, you got to realize, your confidence should be strong based upon what God has already what?
Done.
So now Isaac's 15, 16 years old, and God says, go on and sacrifice him. Put him on the altar. Wait a minute, God. This is all I've been living for. This is all I've been hoping for. And he said, well, just go on and put him on the altar. But here's the point. He knew that he was the God of miracles, and he also knew that he was a God of promise. And if God promised that if God promised that Jesus was going to come through the ancestry of Isaac, then God would have to raise Isaac up, even if Abraham killed him. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
I said, can I get an amen?
Amen.
If Abraham is convinced now, he's not tripping. He's not scared. He's like, I'm going to do what God told me to do. I'm going to take this knife and I'm going to put it down on my son, my only son. But there's only one reason he's doing that. He's not doing that because he's a bad father. Amen. He's not doing that because he's a child abuser. Amen. He's doing it because he has full confidence that if he killed Isaac, God would do what?
Raise
him from the dead. Because he raised Abraham's body from the dead. Abraham couldn't have no children at 100 years old. Sarah couldn't have any children at 90 years old. The Bible says their bodies were as if dead to reproduction. Their reproduction system had shut down. Amen. Somebody. But God said he spoke life where there was death. So Abraham was fully convinced, even if I kill him, God who promised that Jesus would come through him, God's got to raise him from the dead. Somebody say, God's got to do
what
he promised to do. Say, I'm sure about it based upon his track record. That's right, that's right, that's right. So watch this. Look at Genesis 22 and 8. And Abraham said, my son, God will provide himself a lamb for a burnt offering. So they went both of them up to the place of sacrifice together. Do you see that? He is saying, in essence, what he really is saying is, I don't know how God's going to do this, but I know he's going to make a way.
Yes.
See, this is what we got to do. We got to be like Abraham. Stop trying. The Bible says, lean not on your own understanding. It just says, trust in the Lord. You know, there's too many folk that are too smart for their own good. Well, I have to figure it out before God can work. No, God can work even though you can't figure it out. Can I get an amen?
Yeah.
God don't need you to figure it out for him to work. Abraham didn't know how God was going to do it. He just knew that God would do it. That's why I'm telling you today, I'm declaring today to everybody here today, I stopped by here to let you know that you need to hold on to hope. And in the midst of circumstances where you can't see a way, you need to declare that God will make a way. Can I get a witness, somebody? I said,